Hello and what's up everyone, Yudes here again for another video, and today this is going to be my 400k power account. So you've seen my progression guide, if not, links in the description. You've seen me reach 280k, again in the description. Seen me reach 350k for my latest video, and now we are now at 400k. So you know very much how the progress went, and you can still see I still have the first purchase button up here. So if you're doubting that I am free to play, I am definitely 100% free to play, because this bonus still is here. This bonus will go away if you make any purchase into the game, no matter how much it is. Okay, so basically I'm gonna do a rundown on my current build right now and what I have and how I reached 400k, and of course the plans moving on into the future. What are you going to do at this point in the game? So first of all, I just wanted to say the reason why I tried to push for 400k is for a Trial of Ascension 200 hard, right? Because there is a way to beat 200f hard using the team, which is usually Chloe, a DPS plus another monster, right? So usually people went in with, I think they go in with Naomi, Chloe, Bastet. But yeah, the problem with playing as Kina is that sometimes you don't have enough DPS if your monsters are not strong enough. That's why if you look at here and you enter, you actually need around 400k to get the bonus over here. And with this one, it actually makes it so much easier to clear this one, because I had a very, very rough time trying to clear this one on my Kina when I was around 350k at that time. I think that was last week, right? So anyways, that's one of the biggest reasons why I tried to push for 400k power. And yeah, let's go ahead and start off with showing off the summoner. Summoner stats are right here. So HP is just 40k, defense 2000, and attack is 4400. So you can see here the stats are not actually the best, right? I'm pretty squishy. I'm not even 100k power yet, but it works, right? Because as I've said from previous videos, I never really upgraded equipments to their best potential, or by looking, and I was not also looking at the best substats, because right now you can just make do with whatever you get in terms of substats, because this is just for your early game to mid game progression. You don't really need those equipments to be plus 15 yet, because it's not going to be your end game equipment. These are equipments that you just have right now to get by the early and mid game, because there are more raids that are coming up, more content that are coming up that will have better equipment somehow. And yeah, you're not really going to keep these things until the end. Well, it depends on what kind of build you actually want to do. So if you're wondering how you want to, or if you want to plan out, go to your blacksmithing and just look at the descriptions of the equipments over here, right? So it's going to tell you what kind of bonuses you get at level 7 blacksmithing, right? There are effects here that are exclusive for each of the equipments, right? So it just depends on which kind of equipment you really want, and yeah, which bonus you really want for your equipment. So that's how you can plan that one out. And once the raid comes out for that kind of equipment, then definitely farm the heck out of it, right? Anyways, moving back to my summoner. So every equipment you just enhance until failure. You don't have to really push as hard. If you get lucky, then good. If you don't get lucky, then that's fine, right? Most of this is my lowest plus 9, and I don't really want to repair this one because it's going to be expensive, not just on gold but especially on sky stones, because sky stones are super expensive when you do repairs, okay? And for sure, sky stones prices are actually really low right now, but still, it's going to be very expensive, especially in the future, because if you saw the prices for the crafting or enhancements in blacksmithing, it's actually very expensive. And then as for transcendence, this is something that we have to work on at the moment. So we need these energies for transcendence so that we can get to level 65, level 66. Because right now we're capped out at level 64 and I can't actually do much with my Kina at the moment. Next, we have our skills up here. So you can see here the focus of our skills. It's usually just second and third skill. You want to go for the first skill if you want to get more DPS or damage, because this is really just going to be damage with some utility with your Energy of Fire. If you don't know, Energy of Fire is the stacks that you have on top of your head when you're using your basic attack. So it's this one, right? But usually you're not really going to do a lot of damage as Kina unless you're built as a damage DPS Kina, right? But usually you want to prioritize second skill and third skill, because your second skill is usually your buff or somewhat a utility ability, and your third skill is usually your healing ability. Okay, so go for that. And then ultimate, I just usually enhance this one when I can, right? For the passives over here, of course I always just prioritize this one, and then there was, yeah, this thing, attack speed up and damage dealt up if everything is okay with your team, right? If your caster's HP is above 90%, which will usually be the case, you have a lot of attack speed here, and damage dealt up if everything is alive in your team, plus this thing, monster accuracy up 20% if, again, your caster is above 90%, which is most of the time that is the case, right? Unless you're in PvP and something's targeting you right away, right? The passive department always max out evasion and the mana abilities. There is this ability here that's really, really good when it comes to PvE, switching your monsters around so that they can use the skills that you really don't like using during Soul Link, which is really good, and it actually helps out in trying to clear TOA hard 200 as well. Okay, and then for the attribute research, I don't really like upgrading anything here. This was a mistake, but oh well, I did not spend a lot of skill points up there anyway, so that's fine, right? I don't want to reset it for how much? 100k? It's super expensive. I don't want to do that, right? Okay, so that's everything on my summoner. So now let's take a look at the monster stuff. Okay, so how did I reach 400k? It's mostly because of the power of my monster. So we have Bastet over here with already 116k total power. Wait, let me switch my equipment. I think it's the light that has the most power on my equipments, right? And sometimes they affect it because of the gems that you have equipped. So anyways, this is my Bastet. So Bastet is my highest power unit at the moment because she's already max awakened, max skilled, and yeah, max evolved, max level. Alright, so these are the stats. Attack is 2900. HP, because you know, you really just want to ruin your Bastet HP. So 76k and 2500 defense because we have a guard set over here. Accuracy at 40% and resistance at 100%. So the resistance is mostly coming from, not really the substats, but from the book effect of Bastet over here, which is now at level 10. So if you did not, if you were not able to take advantage of the event, then it's going to be hard to get at this point, because, or to get a nat 5 to actually level 10, because that's actually a lot of power that you receive in just one unit, right? So looking at the stats, always look for HP percent on this one. And again, look at the rune here. I have magic grade effect stones and spellbooks equipped as well for each and every rune. Okay, although it's not the best, those are not the best effect stones and spellbooks. It's what I had at the moment. So, oh well. So this one, HP percent, resistance, and defense. This one's a really bad rune, but I mean, we keep it there, right? Crit rate, crit damage, HP percent. So HP percent, okay, good. This one has not much abilities. It's actually for a DPS monster, but oh well, right? This one as well. We have a good effect stone over here with 5% and defense plus 18% over here, which is why I'm keeping this rune. And then we have HP again, HP percent, and attack percent up here. That's pretty high. So that's probably why I kept this rune. But yeah, it's not yet the best runes, but we are already at a very high power. Just to show you, okay, max awaken, max evolve, and max skill ups. Next up, we have Fire Raven Karambit over here. So Karambit is almost 100k power. These are the stats: 3600 attack, 29k HP, attack speed is 189, which is a lot, crit rate 81%, and crit damage 218%. Definitely could do some more work. We want to get this as high as we can, but for now, this is all we got, right? For the runes, it's going to be attack speed, crit damage, and attack. With substats, you want to look for crit damage, attack speed, crit rate, and attack percent. Okay, so those are all the stats that we are looking for the substats over here. And of course, the main stat is very important. Effect stones as well. You can see I have everything equipped too, okay? So yeah, crit rate, crit damage, crit rate, evasion. This one's a really bad rune, by the way. I want to change this one, but anyway. We have attack speed here, crit damage, crit rate. Again, a lot of upgrades went to the flat attack, which is bad. And then attack percent. I don't think I have a better attack percent slot for here. Again, this one got an upgrade with the flat defense, which was bad. If only it all went to attack speed and crit damage, would have been great. But, you know, RNG is RNG, right? So those are the stats. And again, full skilled. And yeah, I got pretty lucky with this guy. I'm already actually at awake 14, so I summoned yesterday and accidentally got one copy of the blessing. So nice. So if you, I think it's still very, very reachable. So this is around 60 copies or 60 pieces, which means you just need 3 dupes. Is that right? 2, 4, 6. Yeah, you just need 3 dupes and you'll be able to get to awake 14 for a single nat 5 monster that you have. So if you've been saving mystical scrolls, at least probably 600 mystical scrolls, and summon it on one banner, I think this is very, very much achievable for a free-to-play player, as long as you really target the correct monsters, right? And again, if you have 600, that's basically 3 guaranteed PT on a single banner, and you have a high chance of getting the nat 5 out of PT as well, or outside PT. So that's basically going to give you awake 14. To get it to awake 15, you need 2 more copies, so a total of 5 dupes for a particular monster. And I don't think I'll be getting mine for a while, so I'll be sitting on the Raven here at awake 14 for probably a few more weeks or months, I don't know. Right, but essentially, if you get them to awake 15, you'll hit the 100k power mark, right? And then again, for the book power, you get book power here. You can see how significant it is, because this one is just level 3, and there are really good bonuses here for the monster. And you can see the gap between Bastet and Karambit over here already. It's almost 15k, probably later on it would reach up to 20k. It depends on the runes, if I can get better runes, right? But anyway, book effects are actually really, really strong and gives a lot of power for the monsters. Next up, we have Naomi, which is my third highest power in the comp in my deck right now. So we have 88k power with Naomi. These are the stats. She has a lot of HP, 30k HP, 3400 attack, attack speed 121, crit rate is 53%, and crit damage 202%. So again, we're aiming for at least around 55% crit rate, so that she can guarantee 100% crit rate with just 3 debuffs. But right now, we're lacking 2% more crit rate, which is fine. That's okay, right? This is already enough, I think, at the moment. Okay, rune wise again, look for crit damage and attack percent is your priority for Naomi, because she doesn't really need a lot of crit rate, right? So mostly focus on crit damage and attack percent. So this is your runes: attack, crit damage, attack. So I have some effect stones, some don't have it, so it's probably something I could work on later on. But yeah, look for crit damage substats as much as you can. Right, this is your crit damage. This one's defense, so this one's not the best. This rune is not the best, so this one as well. So there are still runes here that I can improve upon once I start grinding more runes again. But at the moment, I don't really need more runes to improve my account. Okay, so yeah, that's pretty much it for Naomi. Again, book levels, not a lot, right? I've been very, very unlucky of summoning the Martial Cats. So I'm just at level 3, but again, if you get this one to level 14, that's so much extra extra stats over here that you can get just by summoning, okay? So again, max skilled, max evolve, max awaken, okay? Next up, we have Chloe, which is up here because she's a natural 4-star. If we can awake 15 this one, she might be on par with the stats of Naomi. But yeah, we will only discuss the 3 ones because those are the ones that I have right now equipped to reach 402k power. Okay, after the monsters, other places where you can get stats, I think I mentioned this before already, is put gems, all the gems on your equipments. And if you want, you can also apply effect stones on the weapons and accessories that you have. I have mine for the accessories because I had excess accessory stones, but for the weapons, I don't have it yet because, again, you're not really going to keep those weapons for the late game, so it's just items that you have to get by, right? Anyways, the next part that gives actually a lot of power is Trial of Ascension, these things, Power of Ascension, right? So mine is at 75% progress. You can see the acquired effect here. Prioritize summon power. Summon power is where it increases power for your monsters. And again, any stat that gets added to your monster is multiplied by 3 because you have 3 monsters that are out every single time, right? And then summoner, of course, the summoner effect here is still really good, right? Although it's not the best, it's still okay. It still gives you power. So yeah, these are what I have for my summon power and then immemorial power up here. So if you're wondering how to get to upgrade these things, you have to go to your Spires of Ascension and do your Spires of Ascension. This one, Celestial. If you've completed the stage, there will be challenges for the stages. I think I have mine. Yeah, it's already at 44th floor and you'll see here there are conditions. So place at least one monster with awakening level 4 plus. So once you defeat the floor with this condition, then you're going to get these things, right? Tokens of Test, Token of Guard, and Rahil Medal, right? So those things are acquirable through this location over here at Spires. Okay, so get as high as you can because that's a lot of power that's waiting for you for the Power of Ascensions. Okay, so very important to upgrade these ones because they give a lot of power. And I think we also have the account skill or account, yeah, account skills. Mine is at level 50. My account level is at level 50. So I have pretty much maxed out all the monster 3 skills over here. So again, reason why you want to go for monster 3 here is because it's multiplied by 3. Whereas for your summoner, it's only by 1. Okay, and after going for the 2 monster 3s here, I'm going for attack area over here. Since I'm playing Kina, I'm planning to go summoner cooldown first and then summoner accuracy. After that one, we're gonna go for the tank stats, right? Crit res and everything here. Summoner damage taken, HP, and summoner resistance. Okay, so that's the plan for account skill later on. Okay, and if you're wondering how to get more account skills or account levels, basically just level up all the monsters that you have. So you can see my deck, all the monsters that I have are actually max leveled, right? Everything is leveled up, right? I'm usually just using XP potions. Reason why I have a lot of XP potions, I've been farming a lot of Path of Training for the Energy of Transcendence, this thing, because we need this thing to ascend our character and be able to break the max level. Okay, so at this point, I've shown you everything that I did and I've reached 400k, and I think at this point a lot of people will be bottlenecked, or this is where power progression will slow down. It's because it's really going to be hard to get more power out of monsters at this point unless you get really lucky and you get to build up another 5-star monster that you can add into your roster over here. Right now we have the Chasun event, or the wind sky dancer, but I think it's pretty hard to actually get a lot of this one unless you have a lot of saved up tickets, right? But it's still a very good event where you get the free sky dancer, that wind sky dancer, and that's actually going to be a really good healer for the team as well. Third skill goes through heal block because it only equalizes, it does not heal, increases the HP of the HP with the monster that has the lower HP, right? So it's a really, really good healer, and you can use her in Spires Wind as well if you don't have a wind healer just yet. And again, it's another way for you to actually get a nat 5 monster with max a weekend, potentially. Potentially, right? Especially if you're on the Summoner Pass. Summoner Pass is really just an easy way for people to go on about these events. But of course, if you're free to play, then you can get her as much as you can, get as much copies as you can from those events, right? Because those will help progress your account so much, all right? So anyways, yeah, future plans, what I plan to do with this account. I plan to sleep. I plan to sleep now because there's not much for me to grind on. Anyways, kidding aside, this is the time where you want to start building up other monsters for other contents like spires. Again, the other element monsters. Also, the classes. You have to have good monsters built for each class. And what else? Yeah, PvP. We're going to start building units for PvP. I'm thinking about Espino or Galio soon. The problem is we don't have gold, so right now gold is my focus. And again, we're also working on our professions. Currently stuck with the requirements for master because it's actually very, very expensive. So these are my plans. I'll be working on a lot of things for profession at the moment, trying to push for master right away so that once we finish master, we'll be chilling on in terms of crafting or professions. Other stuff that I want to do as well is to build teams for expedition level 4s, because there are some of these that I still cannot beat at level 4. I think this one is one. Water Hodes, Light Shurekli is one of the problems for me. I really hate Shurekli as a boss because of the requirements that you have to get through his endure buff. So yeah, I still have not cleared level 4. I think Borbo, I should be able to clear Dark Borbo. I don't know why I didn't, but yeah, go for expedition and of course grind a lot of raids as soon as, especially for Naraka, as soon as Naraka comes out, we'll be grinding a lot of that one and getting some random equipments from there as well. And yeah, in terms of power, I really feel like we're gonna be bottlenecked here, but as soon as we build another 5-star that we can use, then we're actually gonna improve our power a lot. I'm actually thinking of a tank. Should not probably be Espino or Galleon here. It's probably Camilla, no? I think I have 40 pieces of Camilla that I can use. Yeah. Level her up. Well, the problem is these units are not free to play, but it's fine. It's fine. It's a time where we start using the good monsters that we have for testing purposes in Arena, because there's a lot of things that we want to do for Arena content as well. Now we also have some set effects in the dress room unlocked. So I think I have 3. So increases Kina attack by 39, Kina HP by 590, and warrior type monster defense by 23. I'm also planning to craft a lot of the costumes here, especially the ones that I can definitely craft already, like this one. It's just normal equipment needed, or the crafting materials are just mineable, gatherable materials. Some of these ones are drops, materials that are drops from subjugation, which I did not have a lot of, right? So some of these ones I will not be able to craft yet. This one I think I can craft this one already. This one too I can craft. And I guess this one as well. So there are some sets here that I can craft already and work on just to get the little amounts of power that's hanging around over here on the costumes side of things. But yeah, that's pretty much it for me. If you have any questions or tips and tricks that you want to share, let me know in the comments below. I usually respond to anyone that puts out any comments. And I also have a Discord server. It's in the description if you want to join and ask questions off stream. And by the way, I stream every day around 6 p.m. Asia time on Twitch, and every Sunday I stream on YouTube. If you have any questions, just drop by. Don't be afraid to ask questions, okay? And yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you very much. Leave a like if this video helps. And of course, subscribe if you have not done so yet. See you again next time. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.